Is it possible to use presenter view while presenting your PowerPoint slides on Zoom? Can you read your speaker notes and know what is going to come in the next animation or on next slide while your audience sees only the slideshow? Yes, it is possible. In this video, I'll show you how to use presenter view while presenting your PowerPoint slides on Zoom. Hi, I'm Ramgopal from presentationprocess.com. We make creative PowerPoint tutorials to help professionals make impactful presentations. If this is your first time to this channel, consider hitting the subscribe button and the bell notification so you don't miss anything. Presenter view is the secret behind many successful PowerPoint presentations. It allows you to be one step ahead of the audience. For example, take a look at this slide. The slide has a number of animations. It also has some useful information in the notes area where I have noted some cool statistics and interesting facts about this slide. If I were to present this slide without presenter view, this is how I would be presenting. Now, I see what the audience sees, and I don't really have any additional information. I don't know when the next animation would come, so I may struggle to present my slides with coherence. Now, take a look at how the same slide can be presented with so much more authority when I use presenter view. Now, to access presenter view, all you need to do is to use the shortcut called Alt F5. The moment you do that, you get this view that gives you total control of your presentation slides. Now, take a look at this. This is the current slide that the audience sees, and this is what is going to come next in the next slide. Now, I can give a brief introduction of what is going to come on the next slide by clicking on this, and then the tool tells me what is going to come in the next animation. So I can say this is the first step in the process. Now, here is the cool part. I can rattle off some cool statistics about this step by looking directly into the speaker notes, which the audience won't see. I also know what is going to come in the next animation, so I can click and reveal the next animation. And here I can give some additional interesting facts that are not already there on the slide, so I can keep my audience always with me during my presentation. And since I know what is going to come on the next animation, I can smoothly transition into the next part of the presentation by saying, the best part about the two-step process is the second step leads to the first step. Not only this, if I want to annotate something on the slide, I can always access the pen and write something here. I also know how much time is spent on this particular slide and so on. So needless to say, presenter view gives you full control as a presenter, and it is essential for you to use presenter view while presenting your slides to any audience. But then the problem is, when you're presenting in Zoom, you don't have that option available directly. Let me show you what I mean by that. Let me go to Zoom and click on New Meeting. And here I am in front of you. Now, if I want to share my PowerPoint screen with the audience, the way I do that is by going to Share Screen option. And here I have the various screens open. If I want to show my PowerPoint presentation, I can go to this option here for PowerPoint and say Share. And this is what the audience sees. And when I go to Slideshow and make the presentation, this is how I would be presenting by default. Now, can you see here, I have the same view as the audience, and I don't have the differential advantage that presenter view gives me. So how do you access presenter view in Zoom so you can stay ahead of your audience at any point of time? It's very simple. It's so simple that you would wonder why you've not used this option so far. Now, all you need to do is to hit escape so you come out of this view. Now, go to the presenter view first. The way you do that is by using the combination called Alt F5. So let us hit Alt F5, and I now have the presenter view available, and I go to the relevant slide. Then I go to the zoom controls. I take my cursor to the top, and here I have the zoom controls, and let me click on the option called New Share. And this is the screen that is presented in front of you. Now, we don't want to use this basic screen option. We want to go to the next option called Advanced. So let me click on Advanced tab, which is right next to Basic. And here I have a wonderful option called Portion of Screen. So let me click on Portion of Screen and say Share. Now that gives me this beautiful rectangle, which I can move at any point of time and can show only that part to the audience. And therefore I can adjust this rectangle in such a way that I show only the slide area here. I can always adjust the size of this rectangular selection by moving the edges like this. So I'm going to ensure that the edges are exactly around the slide area. Now, what the audience sees is this portion, and what I see is this, 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 and this, and so I have full control in the way I present my slides. If I want to impress my audience, I can always read some cool statistics from speaker notes. If I want to know what is going to come next in the next animation, I can access the information here. If I want to move my video, I can always click here and place it somewhere else so that it doesn't come in the way, and I can present my information with full control. It's a simple change in settings, and it can make a significant difference in the way your audience experiences your presentations. Now, to take this information to the next level, I've already created a useful video called How to Record a Slideshow with Narration as a Video in PowerPoint. The link to that video is given right here. So click on the link and take your presentations to the next level.